So, hi, we are the OpenAge maintainers, and this is our yearly update talk. OpenAge is a free engine clone of Age of Empires 2. We are trying to provide the original look and feel of the game. For that, we need to use the original assets, since we are no artists, but we plan to support free replacement asset packs. The project was started 6 years ago when we didn't really know what we were doing. With the main goal of providing unlimited extension possibilities, think about support for more than 8 players, actual sane networking stack, or like a really crazy map, mods like a zombie survival pack or whatever. There is a lot of similar projects for other classic games, which you can see conveniently listed here. The game is based on C++ 17 with Python 3 used for scripting and Cython for the glue layer.
So Age of Empires is still very active even in 2019 because Microsoft just released the definitive edition with vastly enhanced graphics and fancy new UI. We're not quite far, but we're getting there. And this year we mainly had a documentation overhaul with fancy Sphinx stuff, defined our modding API, started the conversion of the original game to that new API, have continuous integration for macOS and Windows, nightly builds for those and Linux, and we have world first SMP conversion for the definitive edition graphics. So with that we can extract for example, Asia graphics set assets. Then we have nightly builds hosted for convenient download and also continuous integration now based on AppWayer. The documentation now looks also way fancier and is easier to browse and read. Maybe you remember from our previous talks that our configuration system was this domain-specific Neon language. We now need to use that to create asset packs. In order to create those, we have to convert the original Genie engine data to our engine, and this is the structure of the converter. So we convert the data to intermediate objects, which we then basically export to our format. And in parallel, we can export the media files, the images, and sounds. Our goal engine architecture looks roughly like that. So we have a separation between the simulation of the game world and the presentation of this game world. So the next steps to reach that is to actually implement the presenter and extend the simulation engine for the actual gameplay features. Then we need scalable pathfinding because, we want to support many, many units. And also think about how we do that over network. With the scripting API, we need to introduce Python stuff, so that also artificial intelligence programming can be done with fancy machine learning, whatever you like. In the past years, we had 140 contributors. So if you have some interest in joining, we'll always be happy about you and you can crunch some issues. To reach us, you can either visit us at our assembly or join one of our chat rooms or write on whatever platform else we have. We also have a blog where we occasionally post status updates, whatever is going on in the project. So in case you want to check us out, here are the GitHub links and we'd be happy to see you contributing. Thanks.
Thank you.